friends, welcome back to my channel. My name's Nicole, and today I'm actually in a new background. I'm actually in Baby Acorn's nursery. I just kind of made it look like it's kind of set up, but really it's still like not even halfway done being set up. So stay tuned for a full reveal. But I thought it'd be the perfect backdrop for today's video. I am talking all about the pregnancy must-haves slash like hacks that you need in your life. If you are pregnant, you want to get pregnant, you're pre-planning, or you aren't pregnant and you just have some aches and stuff and you want some fun ways to help with that, because I feel like other people experience some pregnancy symptoms. So I'm really excited. These are products I have been slowly making a list of over the last, 9 months. I am 8.5 months pregnant. I'm 34 weeks pregnant when filming this. So I have definitely had experience being pregnant and I've been making a list, and there are products, let me tell you, I cannot live without. And I knew I needed to film this video before Baby Acorn arrives, because I know there's so many of you that could really benefit from these products that have really helped me just survive pregnancy, because it is a crazy ride. But these things have really, really helped. So without further ado, let's hop right into the video. Before we officially hop in, if you guys aren't already subscribed, click that red subscribe button down below. Join the Health Nut family and community. I post here every single week on my channel, so you won't miss a video if you are subscribed and you have that notification bell turned on. I think I have about 12 products I'm gonna be talking about, and they're not necessarily in order from like favorite to least favorite, but let me tell you, this first product, it probably is my favorite must-have, most recommended item to you guys, and that is my acupressure mat. So this is actually from the company Bed of Nails. This is their eco-friendly one. So the material, I think, is like a bamboo material. It's a sustainable fabric. I just have pregnancy brain and I can't remember anything these days. This thing, I just don't know what I would have done without it. And I'm still using it, and I will use it postpartum and probably for the rest of my life, because it has just been amazing to have. And how I have been using it for pregnancy is I lay it on the pillows and I lay down on it bare back, skin on the spikes. I know, sounds scary and painful, but it's a little bit, not even uncomfortable, it's just a little bit like stimulating in the beginning, and then you just melt into it. And after laying on it for like 20-30 minutes, wow, it's like it goes from tingling to a deep relaxation. Like, I just took a chill pill and nothing's gonna bother me. It makes me sleepy. It helps if I'm feeling just uncomfortable in my body. I'm just having trouble sleeping. This thing has been a lifesaver, and I even took it with me when I went to the cottage. Like, it comes with me everywhere. There's a travel pack for it. I actually have a link down below. I will actually have a full blog post with all the products that I'm gonna mention in today's video. That will be in the info box down below, so be sure to check that out. But yeah, whether you are pregnant or not, this thing is amazing. I have been doing acupuncture like my whole pregnancy, and I feel like this is just a nice addition, like it complements the acupuncture. And it just does something. I don't know the whole science behind it, but these things are amazing, and I feel like it takes a couple of times using it before you truly fall in love with it. But I use this every night to fall asleep, and everyone's like, oh my god, how's your sleep? You must be so like uncomfortable and waking up throughout the night. No, I'm not. I got my Bed of Nails. Like, it's crazy. So love this thing, and I'm pretty sure you can zip it and wash it and stuff. I haven't done that. I probably should wash it because I use it a lot. So I cannot recommend this mat enough. I tell Matt that if I had to choose one mat, it would be this mat. And I don't think he's offended, because he knows I just love this so much. So first product, acupressure mat. It's amazing. Get yourself one. The next product, which probably comes with no surprise, is a pregnancy pillow. I feel like I just look like one gray blob right now. I thought I did not need a pregnancy pillow, and then we did the Amazon must-have or like highly rated pregnancy items, and this pillow was one of them. Well, let me tell you, it's been my best friend ever since that video. I'd probably, if I had to choose once again between Matt or this pillow in the bed, it would be this pillow. Luckily we have a king bed, because this is like a third person in the bed. So if you have a really small bed, like maybe just kick kick your partner out. It's okay. You need your sleep when you're pregnant. They shouldn't be offended. You have a guest room, put them there. If you have a comfy couch, that's okay. But no, in all seriousness, this thing is amazing. I think when I first tried it, I didn't know exactly how I felt. I was like, oh, I don't know, like, it's okay. I love it. I'll show like a couple positions I've been enjoying using it. I'll sleep on it laying down here, and then sometimes I'll turn and I can still use like these, it's like a big C. I'll show like clips of it to actually explain, but this has a cover you can wash. It's super cozy and comfortable. I felt like there were so many that were so expensive, like over $200. This one I think was like $60. I really, really like it, and it's soft. It's like a, like a jersey material, and I really like it. The one thing I will say is that I don't feel like my belly, it depends like the shape of your belly or how big it is, but I feel like this didn't go underneath my belly enough, like it would pop up. So the other thing I ended up getting later, which I think I did mention in my pregnancy in the Amazon video, which some things will pop up from there, from that video, because I've been using them and really loving them. But that is a wedge pillow. When I first got pregnant, I saw these everywhere online. And I thought, do I need that? Like, it just seems like a gimmicky thing. I don't know if it actually makes a difference. Yes, you need this. If you're just watching TV on the couch, you prop this under your belly and it just supports. There's nothing worse. I'm like all covered in pillows. There's nothing worse than laying on your side and your belly is actually pulling because there's a lot of weight there and it's pulling and twisting and it's really uncomfortable when that happens. So instead of just like grabbing your couch pillows, this actually, like the shape of it is like tapered on one end and it can just fit under your belly and you can watch TV. But at night, I actually prop it in the middle of this. So I have this and then this is underneath and I have like this nice little cove area for my belly to sit in and it's really comfortable. And then if I switch the other way, I can just put this underneath my stomach, or you can even put this under your back. There's a lot of uses for this for pregnancy, but also for postpartum with baby. And I just think it also has a zipper so you can wash it easily. And these two together have been helping me sleep. I love them and I can just get more comfortable wherever I'm laying down. So must have. So if you experience any type of acid reflux, whether pregnant or not, you need this supplement in your life. I am not a doctor or a health professional, so check with your practitioner. But this has been something that has seriously saved me from awful burning acid reflux. I was starting to get it, I'd say early in my second trimester. I was taking a lot of Tums at the time, which I don't really like taking. And I honestly, like looking back, I think it kind of contributed to a lot of my bloating and indigestion that I was having. And this is something that my friend Joy from Joyous Health, who is a holistic nutritionist, she's a friend of mine, and she actually told me about this. I told her I was having a lot of acid reflux, and she said, oh, you gotta try the supplement from Genestra. It's just a magnesium calcium vanilla liquid supplement, and it has this like creamy consistency to it, like a milky creamy consistency. It sounds kind of gross. It's not at all. It tastes delicious. I actually look forward to having a spoonful of this, and because it just tastes like vanilla. It tastes like vanilla cream. I don't know. It's really, really good, but obviously it's a magnesium calcium supplement, so it's something that you usually need when pregnant. But it really helps just like coat and soothe your throat and ease down that acid that's like trying to come up and burn your throat from within. It's awful. And I'd say for most of my pregnancy, I only was using this around like 5 p.m. where I'd start to get some indigestion and like that acid coming up. Now in my third trimester, I'm using this like 3 times a day. It says to take about a tablespoon a day, so I just do like a teaspoon when needed. So I might take up to like 3 teaspoons a day. Or maybe, I think there's 4 teaspoons in a tablespoon. But I just take a little spoonful of this when I get the acid feeling and it helps so much. And it's funny, when I bought this, I'm like, it's such a big tub. Like, what? I'm not gonna go through this. I am now, oh, I can't really see through it. I must be like down to here now. So I might actually end up repurchasing another one before baby comes. That's how much I love it. You have to try this. I just think it's a way better option than Tums. Love this. The next like category of items that have been really essential, no pun intended, during my pregnancy has been essential oils. If you follow me on Instagram, you probably hear me talk about them all the time. I've been using them for years, more intensely in the last, I'd say, year and a half. And when I got pregnant, I cannot tell you how much I've been relying on these for just like at home, non-toxic remedies for all these symptoms that I've been having. So I'll show you, I actually have this like really cute little oil pack. We just started selling these on the shop, so I'll link them down below, because we did get some questions about them. But there are, this is like my little pregnancy must have like first aid kit with me. I bring it everywhere. If we're going somewhere for more than a few hours, I pop it into my travel bag or my purse. I'll take a couple and I never leave without it, especially if I'm sleeping over somewhere. This is coming with me. So some of the products, I'll go through them really quickly. I'll talk more about them in the blog post. The ones I would say I used a lot right in the beginning were lavender and peppermint. I was getting really bad migraines when I got into my second trimester. I also got a few headaches in my first, but peppermint and lavender, I would just put them on the temples and my forehead and the back of my neck. And I feel like once I started to do this, I didn't even have to resort to like Tylenol and stuff like that. And these helped so much, just really helped relieve those like that pounding migraine headache that you can usually get when you're pregnant, or just a lot of people deal with headaches. And I just think these have really helped me. I have a rollerball on the lavender one because I just use lavender for like everything, but peppermint's really good for like nausea and digestion and the headaches. It really helps give you some relief. And then the other thing that I used so much, I actually went through, this one's empty. No, it's almost empty. I went through like two bottles of this. Digize. This is a blend that specifically by Young Living that they make. And that's why I really like Young Living. Not only are their oils really high quality, but they also have really good blends that you can't find anywhere else. So this one is Digize. It has like a ton of different oils like fennel and peppermint, all this stuff. And I was having such bad bloating and indigestion in my beginning of my second trimester, where I felt like I couldn't eat anything without feeling like I was blown up like a balloon. It was really uncomfortable. And I started using this. I have a roller ball on it. I just take it and roll it around my stomach, and I'd say within 20 minutes, I felt some relief. That really uncomfortable, tight feeling just felt a little bit more at ease. And it has a very strong smell. I wouldn't diffuse this one in the air. Some people really like it. It's just like a very like herbally intense smell. But I always had this in my purse because if I ate anything immediately, I would put this on, and it really helped. The other ones are just kind of like emotional support ones. This is a peace and calming one. It's a blend. It's amazing. I love it. It's so relaxing and soothing. You can deal with a lot of emotions, a lot of anxiety and stress when you're pregnant, especially when you're pregnant during a pandemic. This has been so helpful and it smells amazing, so I use it as a perfume. And then Valor, which is the bravery oil, but also really good for emotional support. And these two, I would just like kind of go back and forth between them. I would just use it on my wrists. I would just inhale it, take some nice deep breaths, and I feel like it would just take the edge off and really help relax me and just soothe like any anxious feelings. And then at bedtime, pregnant or not, I use this every single night. The Tranquil blend, which has like Roman chamomile in it, cedarwood, lavender, and I just take this every night. I roll it up and down my wrists, and then on my chest and a little bit on my neck, and I sleep like a baby. That's all I'm saying. So I will have all of these oils and the benefits to them and stuff in the blog post, but these have been my favorite while being pregnant. Next item is magnesium. Magnesium has been my best friend. I have been getting horrible restless legs at night and just like calf leg cramping because the baby is sucking all of the nutrients from me. And even though I take my prenatals and my supplements, she's greedy. She's taking all the magnesium, like not leaving any for me. So at night, you know, it's usually when you're like trying to rest and relax is when things start to pop up. You feel more achy, and my legs are, has been getting progressively worse throughout my pregnancy. But they get like so, it's just like uncomfortable feeling like you gotta move your legs. It's like a dull, achy pain. If you've ever dealt with restless legs, you probably know what I'm talking about. but it's really annoying. And these products have helped so much. So in conjunction with taking a magnesium supplement, and I have this, like my midwife, my doula, and my acupuncturist / naturopath, they all know everything I'm taking, so don't worry, this is safe for me, but check with your health professionals. From what my understanding is, a lot of people are lacking in magnesium, and you're not really gonna overdose in magnesium by like taking like topical things like this. So I'll talk about baths. I was not really taking baths in the first half of my pregnancy, and later I discovered the wonders of a bath. A bath is so soothing at night. It's great for relaxation, it's great for digestion, like it just feel like, I don't know, just relaxes the body. But what I've been adding to my bath is what has been making the difference, and that is things that are rich in magnesium. So even if you just have like sore muscles, these are great, but they are really good for just like pregnancy aches and the restless legs. So I have a couple items. I have these magnesium bath salts that I'll put in. And then I also have these were mentioned in my Amazon video. I have these Dead Sea salts that are really high in magnesium. So I will do a combination of these, but you can do like Epsom salts, whatever you want. These are just like what I have had on hand. And then more recently, in the last few weeks, I got this magnesium balm. It's just, I don't know why it has like two colors. I don't know if it's a chemical reaction with the magnesium, but it kind of turns like pink. Anyways, this stuff is awesome. Matt massages my calves with this at night, and I feel like within 20, 30 minutes, I noticed some relief. So this has been amazing. I basically put this on every single night. You can put this on anywhere in your body, but it's just magnesium chloride. It's a magnesium chloride balm. And it's all natural, fragrance-free. I'll put this brand down below, and I love it. So baths and magnesium have been amazing for just like aches, pains, but the restless legs that are so annoying. So get these if you're having that issue too. The next item, I actually have a few items in this category to share. It's some essentials or like basic clothing items that have really helped me. So I have them all here in the crib, and I'm just gonna show you guys what they are. So first thing I started to get when I got pregnant was bras, because that was like the first thing that grew were my boobs, and I couldn't wear any of my bras. Like, they were so uncomfortable. So I started to look for really comfy ones that would just get me through my pregnancy. And I really felt like Aerie like knocked it out of the park. I use them for so many pregnancy, like maternity clothing items this year. They were like usually on sale, super affordable. Just the fabrics and the fit were right on point. And I have so much Aerie stuff now. So their bras, amazing. So I really like their sports bras. If you've been following me on Instagram and you see me working out with my trainer Laura, then you'll know I'm usually wearing one of these. I have a bunch of different colors. These are two different styles. If they still have them, I'll link them, but like so comfy. Like, I cannot recommend these enough. I love the different colors and fits. And then also these ones are just like super comfortable ribbed ones. I have this in white and black, because when you find, oh no, in a like a mauve-y, like purpley pink. When you find a bra that's really comfortable, you should just get it in a couple colors. That's what I did. And these are gonna be great for postpartum, but also just like for life. Like I basically got, you know, my regular size or just a little bit roomier. Actually, you know what? What did I get in these? I got medium. I probably would have gotten medium before too, but they just work more comfortable for my growing breastuses. And yeah, this one's great too. Super great just to lounge around the house. But if you're like being active, walking or whatever, these are awesome. Because you still like wanna wear a bra sometimes because your boobs are getting bigger, but you just don't wanna feel restricted. So these have been awesome. The other thing that I used a lot of this summer, and these probably look really well loved, and they're a little pilly now and they have some dog hair on them. But these shorts, they're actually from Aritzia by the brand TNA. And I have them in this like grayish purpley color. Chloe and I were discussing whether this is gray or purple. And I have a black pair. And these were so popular this summer. Like the whole biker short trend, really, really trendy this year, which was great for my pregnant body because this band here just kind of sat right under my belly. It didn't roll down. I loved them, and it's just a little chilly now to wear them. But if you live in a hot climate, These would be great. So pretty much my summer outfit was these shorts, one of these bras, and like a tank or t-shirt, and I was just really comfortable all summer. The other things I would mention, I'm kind of showing you in the order that I discovered them and added them to my maternity wardrobe. None of these are maternity, by the way. Those came later, and I'm still not really fully wearing maternity clothes, except actually what I'm wearing now. I finally like popped to the point I can't really not wear maternity stuff, but a lot of things got me through and just fine. So these bra tank tops from Uniqlo are amazing. I got them in two colors. I could have gotten them in more. I got them in a nude, like taupey nude, and a black, and they have these like built-in bras in them. So comfortable. I think these are normally $29. I got them on sale for $19. So comfy. If you don't like wearing a bra or any undergarments like me, these are really comfy, and I just really loved them. I thought they were really comfortable while being pregnant. And then the other thing during summertime, but also like in the fall, you gotta watch out for the sun. Your skin is really sensitive to the sun, even more so when you're pregnant. So of course I would wear sunscreen, but something that I think it's overlooked is a good hat. Because if I was going to the beach or taking Cash for a walk or hiking, I would just throw on a hat, and at least it was protecting my face, because you can easily get like pigmentation, darker pigmentation and stuff from the sun, because your skin gets really sensitive. You can burn easily. So just having a good hat was really helpful, so I didn't get overheated and not, so I wouldn't get like heat stroke or headaches, but also would protect my face. Then recently I got these really comfortable jogger, like yoga pants. These are from Lululemon. They're called the Align Joggers. And I originally went in for the Align yoga pants, which I'm probably gonna go back and get. But anything from the Align line, whether it's the shorts, the pants, or the joggers, I think are great for pregnancy. They're really stretchy, and the band fits really nicely under the belly. And the best part is I can wear these postpartum. So I just got the Army Green. They're kind of slouchy. They got pockets, and they have this really nice comfy band. So just super cozy for being pregnant. I could have gotten these earlier. I just discovered them, but I want to let you guys know so you can discover them early, and they're just the comfiest thing. Next item, which may seem obvious, is having a good water bottle. I have many water bottles that I've been bringing with me wherever I go, because like just staying hydrated is so important when you're pregnant. Like you got more fluids coming in and out, the baby uses up a lot of fluids, and you need to stay hydrated. If I wait too long without drinking water, I just get this insanely thirst, and it's really hard to quench. So two water bottles I've been really liking is this tall one. I usually bring this with me like on the go, in the car. I'll even just carry it around the house with me. So this one's great. It's just glass. It's really easy to clean, and it has a little silicone sleeve on it. And then this one, I usually have the white one, but we just got in this eucalyptus color. It's so pretty for the fall. This one's really great because what makes this one different is that it's super lightweight. I can fill this one up, take it with me on a walk or a hike with Matt and Cashew, and I don't feel like I'm carrying this like heavy glass or metal water bottle. It also is collapsible, so you can collapse it down once you're done drinking out of it. And I really love this one. It's also dishwasher safe. So once you're done, you just stick it in the dishwasher and you're good to go. And I just love it. It comes in white and this like pretty eucalyptus blue, greeny color. Speaking of snacks and drinking and on the go, these reusable silicone bags are everything. I use these a lot in the house for like storing leftovers, for freezing bananas for my smoothies, but I've been making snack packs. Because you don't leave the house, this is like something you learn very early on in pregnancy. You don't leave the house without snacks, because as soon as you leave, you're gonna be in the car or doing whatever you're doing, and you're gonna be hungry. And if you don't have snacks, like you just start to get hangry, lightheaded, like things progress really quickly when you're pregnant, and it's not a fun time. So I love these. They're reusable, they're dishwasher safe, they seal really tight, so you don't have to worry about them leaking or spilling. And there's different sizes. There's like little snack pack sizes. These are the medium ones. And they're just really handy for, I usually put like a mixture of dried fruit and nuts in them, or sliced up apple, trail mix, granola, whatever you want. I will sometimes just have a couple of these in the car with us, and they're just great because you don't have to worry about like using disposable, like one single use plastics and stuff. These are great. And like I said, super easy to wash and reuse. The next item was another thing that was mentioned and featured in my Amazon pregnancy video, and that is the squatty potty. This is actually the one that this actually collapses, which I think is handy if you're having guests over and you want this like big plastic bathroom stool in your bathroom. Maybe you don't care, I don't know. But our bathroom's small, and so this one actually the legs fold in. But this thing is amazing. If you poop, which I know you all do, you need a squatty potty. Whether you get this one or the other one, I think they're about the same price. It's amazing. I know so many people that have these rave about them because once you start using this, you just can't poop without it. And yes, we're talking about poop because when you're pregnant, that is the topic of discussion. Honestly, anytime I see my midwife or my doula, they're like, how are your bowel movements? It's like the first question, like, hi, nice to meet you. How you doing? But this has been really good. It just puts your body into optimal position to have a good bowel movement. And I just think that good poops are important. And I love this thing and I use it every single morning. And I think I'm slowly getting Matt into it. I don't know if he loves it as much as I do, but I'm really enthusiastic about it because it's just made my digestion and pooping game really, really good. So anyways, TMI, but not really, because healthy poops are healthy. So get yourself a potty squatty. You'll like, once you start using it, you're going to be addicted. Trust me. And you'll be talking about it. It's like when I discovered the Diva Cup, it's like that. It's one of those like TMI things, but really more people need to talk about it, because if you find something that helps, you should just tell everyone. Everyone needs to know. Next category. I mean, I could talk forever about skincare. You guys know I have switched basically all of my skincare to natural products over the last few years, but things that I've been really using while pregnant are things that are like really hydrating. For some reason, when you're pregnant, it's like your skin like gets all dry so quickly. It needs all this moisture. And it's not just like belly creams. It's like everywhere, it just seems really dry. So as I'm like, I'm getting itchy now thinking about it. So obviously the first thing that you probably think of when people are pregnant is you need something to moisturize the belly. Some people say it doesn't help. I think it does. Like I was talking to my eyebrow girl, Marina, the other day about this, and we were kind of comparing it to, that's like saying that skincare doesn't do anything. You can tell a difference between someone who has a good skincare regimen and someone who just like washes their face with soap and foot cream. You know what I mean? Like actually my best friend used to do that because she has perfect skin and she can use anything. But what I'm getting at is you definitely can tell a difference. These things do help. Yes, it doesn't mean you're not gonna get stretch marks entirely, but I have been making my own. I call this my blue belly oil. I have a full IGTV video on how to make it. I will link it down below in the blog post. This has jojoba oil, which is the carrier base to this, and some amazing essential oils that are so skin soothing and supporting. And this I've been using and making throughout my whole pregnancy, and I feel like it's really helped hydrate my skin. I haven't gotten like those super itchy dry patches that some people get, and I think it's just really helped with the stretching and growing. Also, it's very calming, so I use this morning and night, and I've probably made about 4 batches of this already. It's amazing. And I also use this on my face at night. It's just a really great skin loving oil. Also, other things, if I want just like a bit of extra hydration, this skin butter from Luminance. I love everything from Luminance. This stuff I just drink through. I just soak up, and I put this, sometimes layer it over top of the belly oil. I'll put this on my hands, my calves, anywhere that's feeling dry. Sometimes like my shoulders where like a lot of sun was hitting was getting dry, and I was using that. The other thing, this is more so first thing in the morning. I wake up in the morning. You get like a lot of congestion when you're pregnant and your like nose is dry, your eyes are dry in the morning. First thing I do in the morning is I take this out and I like spray it in my eyes, and it just hydrates my eyes because I wear contacts and my eyes are so dry in the morning. This, or even in the middle of the night, if I get up to go pee, my eyes are just like the moisture gone. I put this on, it helps. And then last but not least, you guys know the best lip balm ever. My lip butter from Beauty Nut Skincare, it's the best. This is like the size of a glue stick. It's a chubby guy. And, you know, this is great not only for your lips, but if you have any other dry patches, you can use it as like an all-purpose moisture stick. This is great. So these were kind of like my favorite hydration products I've been using while pregnant. Love them. And yeah, belly oil recipe will be linked in the blog post. This next item we just got in the last week, and wow, it's the best. It is a massager. It actually comes in this little case, which is really handy, so you can like store it away easily. So kind of looks like a bowling bag, put down the ground. This thing, I mean, mainly we got it because Matt is not the best massager. Like, God bless him, he's amazing in so many ways, but massaging is not his forte. And he's like always like, my hands are getting crampy, and he complains, and it's really annoying. And he'll give me a massage if I'm feeling like achy, but like he does it while complaining. So it's kind of bulky, and it seems like a weird thing to like buy, but let me just show you. Put your arms in here. And these, like, there's so many different brands of this, and I'm gonna turn it on in a sec, but basically does like a shiatsu massage. Anyways, this kind of just helps put some like weight on your back, and you just turn it on. And there's also like, do you see the heat? Oh, there we go, the light. And, oh, gets right in. I can't tell you how good this feels. Like, who needs a partner? Got this and my acupressure mat, I'm good. So this helps. If you ever have like one of those pinching pains in your neck that you just can't get out, this is amazing. You can actually do it on your whole back. You can bring it down and like get it into the spot. And I'll actually lay my, I just can't, T-Rex arms. I'll actually lay my legs and my calves and stuff on it for a leg massage. Wow. So this thing, like, you just do it yourself, you know? Like, this is awesome. So I've been doing about like 20, 30 minutes. This thing is the best, and I'm so happy we got it. Oh. So this is great, and like I said, it just packs up in the little carrying case. And now I have a massage guaranteed every single night without complaint. So those were my must-have pregnancy items. You guys need to try these if you're pregnant. I'm gonna have the full blog post linked down below with all the items, all the links, some more descriptions and information about everything. I hope this video was helpful and it gave you some ideas just to help give you like some natural remedies for a lot of symptoms that you experience while pregnant that are not so fun. When everyone says like, don't you just love being pregnant? I just think, do you want the real answer? Like, yes, it's been lovely. There are many things that are exciting, feeling baby move, but like, I kind of miss having a good night's sleep without having to use magnesium balm, my acupressure mat, and my massager, and my pregnancy pillow, and all these things. But having them has made the pregnancy experience that much easier to live with and adapt. So hopefully you guys found this video helpful. If you guys have any of your own suggestions or must-have products, leave me a comment down below. As always, don't forget to subscribe. I post here every single week, and give it a thumbs up if you liked it, because it really helps support my channel. I will see you guys in the next video, and have a fabulous day.